Hello. In this video, I will talk about how we as humans actually create the urban climate. Shaping the urban climate depends on the structure and the materials that the city is made of. That urban climate differs from climate in landscapes. The urban climate is often drier and warmer than natural landscapes, and of course, the heat loads that we experience from global warming adds extra up to these urban heat effects. The urban climate also shows great differences in the wind field. Some places are more windy, some places are more protected, and many changes in the urban structure also change the urban climate. So that's why it is so important to know the effects of design interventions, or basically how we can shape the urban climate through urban design. But how do you actually experience urban climate in everyday life? Urban heat can form a problem. Over day it's, for instance, so hot that we have to look carefully for a shade outdoors. At the night, maybe it's too warm in your houses and it keeps you from sleeping, and it makes you very dull and inefficient at your workplace tomorrow. Of course, the urban heat can also be very beneficial if you want to stay outdoors at night with your friends having a beer, but mostly the problems prevail. Wind in the city is quite turbulent, and it can be unpleasantly surprising by its gusts. For instance, I was once blown off my bike at the foot of a tall building. We can also face discomfort when crossing large squares, as you see in the picture, because the wind speeds can be quite high there in these places too. On the other hand, wind can also be very convenient, for instance, as a cool breeze during hot days. That's why you put on your fan, right? But there are also many places in cities where there is little wind because they are protected by buildings and other volumes, for instance, trees. But of course, we do not feel sun, shade and wind separately from each other. Our temperature sensation depends on different factors: shortwave radiation from the sun and its reflection from urban surfaces, and of course, if you enter a shaded place or not. So that is how you normally feel the influence of the shortwave radiation from the sun. And then there's also long wave radiation. Or in other words, it's the warmth that is emitted from objects in the city. For instance, when you're sitting in front of the wall that has been warmed over day and it is still emitting heat at night, that's what you can feel as the long wave radiation. Apart from that, wind, air temperature, and also a little bit the relative humidity of the air play a role in how you experience temperature as a totality. But our thermal perception is not only influenced by these physical factors that we've just seen. It also plays a role what age and gender you are, what you wear, of course, how your metabolism works, to which climate you are used to, and also in which temperature environment you have just been before. Also, psychological factors play a role, such as your mood, the company that you have when you're outdoors. All this has an influence on how you experience the microclimate. But of course, all this cannot be changed by urban design. On the other hand, as you can imagine, the wind can be changed very well through urban design on a local scale. Also, the shortwave radiation, so sun and shade, and longwave radiation, depending on the materials of the urban environment, they can be changed very effectively with local design interventions. The air temperature and the relative humidity can also be influenced, but then by larger scale design interventions or adding up many small interventions. But also the ambience of the space that you are in has an influence how you experience temperature. And this ambience can also be manipulated through the design of the urban space that you're in. I will show you in the following which types of design interventions are apt to change temperature-related factors, wind and ambience. If you want to provide shade close to buildings, you can shape the buildings themselves accordingly, for instance, by building arcades under the buildings or attached to them, such as the Plaza Mayor in Madrid, or by additions to buildings, such as the Louvre balcony in Salzburg. If you want to provide shade in public spaces, you can use fixed elements or flexible elements, such as the movable curtains above a street in Santa Barbara, or flexible elements such as the movable awnings in Mumbai. If you want to create shade, you can of course also use vegetation. The vegetation can consist of freestanding trees or hedgerows, but it can also grow on trellises or pergolas. The great advantage of vegetation is that it also tempers the air temperature through evapotranspiration. If you might know, evapotranspiration is the water that is emitted by plants via their stomata. So this vegetation does a double duty for prevention of urban heat. This cooling effect of greenery through evapotranspiration can also be enhanced in places where shade for people outdoors is not so important. For instance, green walls and green roofs, in case they are really thick green roofs. These can lower air temperatures and also the temperature in the buildings themselves. And of course, also water can help to cool the air temperature, but only when it is very finely dispersed. It is really important that the water is moving, because still water bodies actually store heat and will emit extra heat in warm nights. As we know, wind can be a nuisance and then it should be blocked. For instance, with wind shields or with hedgerows. And when wind shields are a bit permeable for airflows, the wind protected area behind the shield is actually also bigger. Well, obviously, it is sometimes also desired to have actually some ventilation when it's too warm. Then it is important to actually keep areas in the city or in the city fringes open, such as open squares, water surfaces, or open parks, so that the wind can roam freely. Last but not least, in urban design, it is also possible to influence the ambience of a space. For instance, in Western Europe, people like to stay in urban environments that have warm colors and materials that have this kind of warm feel as well, and people feel thermally comfortable there. But in other countries, people have really different preferences. So, in which materials and colors of an urban environment would you feel thermally comfortable?